Hello everybody, Andrea here with Dental L. So let's talk about how you can ease your patients' fears around COVID and protocols and the dental office, all of that. It doesn't matter if your patient's nervous about COVID, but you know, they're not doing too bad coming to a dental office, or they're terrified, they don't want to come to the dental office, it took them forever to book their appointment. You just don't know. So please keep in mind, even if a patient doesn't appear nervous to you, they're not asking a lot of questions, they might still be nervous about coming to see you. You just never know. So I want to explain how you can really ease your patient's fears in regards to our new COVID world right now. You know, it's really true, and how the dental office is changing. And I challenge you to think of yourself at the same time. I say that because I prefer to stay home. I don't really like to go out either, but mainly because I want to keep myself safe, but also my patients safe as well, since I'm still working. But I find it very annoying with certain things. Like, for example, when I take my dog to the vet, I can't go in there because they don't allow us to go in with our dog. They just simply take the dog, and we have to trust they're giving them the right needles, they're treating them well, you know, all kinds of things. So your patients are probably concerned about the same thing. So your patient, let's say a parent, your patient's child has a dental appointment. Well, let them know before their appointment that they cannot come in with their child, if that's your office protocols. Because the worst thing you can do is not explain the COVID protocols and then start to explain them when your patient arrives. That's the worst thing possible. So do the best you can to inform them. That's really number one. Inform your patients of your new COVID protocols, whether it be by social media, have several posts, not just one post, but I suggest perhaps a post a week. Send out an email if you have an email list, have signs outside the office door, you know, things like that. To be informed is the best thing possible. Another quick example, I had a car maintenance appointment of mine. They didn't send out emails, nothing about their COVID protocols. I assumed it was the same as the last time I had my car serviced, which was just a few months ago, where I would, you know, we have to wear masks. We can only go in at our allotted time, but we still had access to the waiting room. Only a certain amount of people were allowed in, you know, I could go on. But the morning of my appointment, they basically sent me a text message and said, please text us when you arrive. You cannot stay. You have to leave, basically. And I always stay for my car maintenance appointments. So I kind of called them back and said, okay, A, I wasn't aware of this. I don't have transportation. I'm not going to hang around in the freezing cold in the middle of nowhere for 2 hours. That's how long the appointment would have taken. So I said to them, I'm canceling my appointment because I wasn't aware of this. If they had just made me aware, I could have made, you know, other transportation methods, right? I could have asked somebody to pick me up. But that's what I mean. I was very, very frustrated and very upset when I didn't have to be. So think of your patients. Let them know before they arrive what will be happening, such as when you arrive, text us, somebody will come out to take your temperature. You will then not be allowed to wait in the waiting room. You have to wait outside. You know, whatever your policies are, let them know either by phone call, social media, however you want to do it. What I do is I have posts on social media. If I'm talking to a new patient, I might say to them, have you seen our COVID protocols on social media? Yes or no. If you have not, here is the link to my website where I list them all right there for you. Please let me know if there's any questions. And this way too, I don't have to constantly text the same person about my COVID protocols. I don't have to talk to the same person about my COVID protocols. I do still talk to them about it, but it's just kind of easier to send them to a website so I don't forget anything. But that's mainly just for those people who might cancel their appointment short notice if they weren't aware, like, oh, I can't go in with my child. Okay, this is just weird, you know. Now, I'm a mobile hygienist, so things are very different. I don't have the same protocols that you guys have. For example, when I go into somebody's home, well, they can be with their child, no problem, because it's their own home. So no big deal. But going to a dental office, you might have those policies where they can't. So does that make sense, you guys? I realize if you work for a dental office, you might not have control over social media, their website, all of that. But then be prepared for your patient to come in and ask questions. So at the very least, when you bring your patient in, before you start anything, say, "Hi, Mr. Smith, it's so nice to meet you," or "It's so nice to see you again. Do you have any questions in regards to our COVID protocols?" I explain things as I go along, but please don't hesitate to ask me any questions. So does that make sense, you guys? I hope that helps. Please let me know, comment below if I can help in any other way, and good luck seeing your patients, and stay safe out there.